Once upon a time, in the land of Hushabye, they came across a sort of box, bound up with chains and locked with locks, and labeled, "Kindly, do not touch. It's war." A decree was issued all about, all with a flourish and a shout, and a gaily colored mascot tripping lightly on before. "Don't fiddle with this deadly box, or break the chains, or pick the locks. And please, don't ever mess around with war." Well, the children understood. Children happened to be good, and they were just as good round the wondrous days of yore. They didn't try to pick the locks or break into the deadly box. They never tried to play about with war. Mommies didn't either. Sisters, aunts, grannies neither, because they were quiet and sweet and pretty in those wondrous days of yore. Well, much the same as now, and not the ones to blame somehow for opening up that deadly box of war. But someone did. Someone battered in the lid and spilled the insides out across the floor. A sort of bouncy, bumpy ball made up of guns and flags and all the tears and horror and the death that goes along with war. Well, it bounced right out and went bashing all about and bumping everything in store. And what was sad and most unfair is that it didn't really seem to care much who it bumped, or why, or what, or for. It bumped the children mainly, and I'll tell you this quite plainly, it bumps them every day, and what is more, it leaves them dead and burned and dying, thousands of them sick and crying, because when it bumps, it's really very sore. But there's a way to stop the ball. It isn't difficult at all. All it takes is wisdom, and I'm absolutely sure we could get it back into the box and bind the chains and lock the locks. But no one seems to want to save the children anymore. Well, that's the way it all appears, because it's been bouncing round for years and years, in spite of all the wisdom whizzed since those wondrous days of yore. And the time they came across that box, bound up with chains and locked with locks. Labeled. Kindly, do not touch. It's war.